Exhaustion is real. What kind of stress mother goes through, you will understand only when you step into the shoes of a mother. It's hard. It's definitely very hard. But what I've seen is people tend to provide solutions which mask the problems or which give short-term solutions. But is that going to really help the mother in the long term? Is that going to solve the problem for her? Absolutely not. And to just give you an example, so many parents I have, interacted with in terms of sleep consultations. I've seen their babies being prescribed with so-called safe sleep medications just to lengthen the sleep duration. For babies who are absolutely healthy, growing well, and with no other issues of any sort. Now, there lies a huge problem. Yes, the parents might get a couple of nights of longer sleep, but I probably would wake up so many times to check on my baby if the baby is doing fine, and ultimately it's doing no good. Then you will ask, is there nothing that can be done to improve quality of sleep or improve the length of the sleep? Of course you can. Once you understand the biology of baby sleep, how many times does a baby nap at a particular age? What is the total number of hours a baby need to sleep in a day? How does the baby's sleep cycle work? It is so much more easier to help the baby sleep in a better way, to get into sleep cycles easily, to help the baby sleep, to know the sleep cues, to avoid overtiredness, and so many more things. And I feel doing this will automatically provide parents with a long-term solution, with a long-term key to unlock the sleep problems of the baby, rather than resorting to medications which will do more harm than good. So this is more of an awareness post which I wanted to do, just to let parents know that please check before giving any medications to your child, to your babies, and make sure what you are giving is what you know. Take care.